Hello, my reading friends. Welcome to Bilingual Storytime. Today, we are going to read, We Do Not Eat Our Classmates. 开始吧。We don't eat our classmates.
我们不吃我们的同学。
By Ryan T. Higgins.
作者瑞安·希金斯。
Penelope Rex was nervous. It's not every day a little T-Rex starts school.
佩内洛普·克里斯很紧张，并不是每天都有小霸王龙去上学。
What are my classmates going to be like? Will they be nice?How many teeth will they have? This was very important.
我的同学们会长什么样子呢？他们会很友好吗？他们有多少颗牙齿呢？这很重要。
Penelope's mom brought her a new backpack with ponies on it.
佩内洛普·克里斯的妈妈买了一个新的书包给她，上面印有小马。
Ponies were Penelope's favorite because ponies are delicious.
佩内洛普·克里斯最喜欢小马，因为小马很美味。
Penelope's dad packed her a lunch of 300 tuna sandwiches.
佩内洛普·克里斯的爸爸给他打包了300个金枪鱼三明治。
And one apple juice.
和一罐苹果汁。
Finally, the big day came.
终于重要的这一天到来了。
And Penelope Rex was very surprised to find out that all of her classmates were...
佩内洛普·克里斯惊讶地发现她的同学们是...
Children!
孩子们。
So she ate them because children...are delicious.
因此他就把他们都吃掉了，因为小朋友太好吃了。
Penelope Rex, said Mrs. Noodleman, we don't eat our classmates. Please spit them out at once. So she did.
佩内洛普·克里斯，面条老师说。我们不可以吃同学们，请把他们吐出来。他吐了出来。
It was not the best way to start school.
这并不是上学的最佳开始方式。
Still, Penelope was determined to have a good first day.
这并不是上学的最佳开始方式，但佩内洛普决定继续期待有一个愉快的一天。
She tried hard to make friends at recess.
在课外活动期间，她努力地想去交朋友。
She finger painted some of her best work.
他用手指画出他认为最好的作品。
She even saved Griffin Ermy a seat at lunch.
在吃午餐的时候，他甚至给格里芬艾默留了个位置。
You can sit here.
你坐这儿吧。
Penelope started to notice everyone was making friends.Her.
佩内洛普注意到，大家都交到了自己的朋友。 除了他以外。
It was lonely.
他是寂寞孤独的。
When she got home, her dad asked her about her first day of school. I didn't make any friends, Penelope cried. None of the children wanted to play with me.
回到家后，他的爸爸问他，在学校的第一天感觉怎么样？
我没有交到朋友，佩内洛普哭着说，没有小朋友愿意和我一起玩。
Penelope Rex, her father asked, Did you eat your classmates? Well, maybe sort of, just a little bit.
佩内洛普·克里斯，他的爸爸问道，你吃了你的同学吗？
有那么一点点。
Sometimes it's hard to make friends, said her dad, especially if you eat them.
他的爸爸说，有时候交朋友会有些难，尤其是你吃了他们后。
You see, Penelope, children are the same as us on the inside, just tastier.
你看，佩内洛普，小朋友的内心和我们是一样的，你要学习。
That gave Penelope a lot to think about.
这让佩内洛普陷入深深的思考中。
The next day, Penelope tried really hard.
第二天，佩内洛普真的很努力。
But poor Penelope, she just could not stop herself from eating her classmates.
可是，可怜的佩内洛普，她不能控制自己去吃同学。
Mrs. Noodleman, Penelope ate William Omato again.
面条老师，佩内洛普又把威廉大本吃到肚子里了。
And they were all afraid of her.
这让大家都好怕她。
Except Walter. Walter was a goldfish.
除了沃尔特以外，因为沃尔特是一条金鱼。
So Penelope tried to make friends with him.
所以佩内洛普尝试跟他做朋友。
Will you be my friend?
你愿意做我的朋友吗？
Jump!
赶紧！
Cried Penelope. He's eating my finger! Wah!
啊！
佩内洛普哭了起来。
他咬我的手指。
Once Penelope found out what it was like to be someone's snack, she lost her appetite for children.
佩内洛普感受到了成为别人的零食是一种什么样的感受后，她便不再有吃孩子的胃口了。
She stopped eating her classmates.
她不再吃她的同班同学。
Even when.C.C. Woodman spilled
barbecue sauce
all over herself.
即使倩倩伍德曼把烧烤酱溅到她的身上。
And soon Penelope made friends.
没过多久，佩内洛普就交到了朋友。
Found you.
找到你了。
Want a brownie?I helped make them.
想要巧克力饼吗？我帮着做的。
Now, even when children look especially delicious, she peeks at Walter and remembers what it looks like when somebody tries to eat you.
现在，
即使同学们看起来特别的秀色可餐，他也会瞥一眼沃尔特，让他想起被人吃的感觉。
In water, the goldfish stares right back at her and licks his lips.
而沃尔特，这条金鱼正盯着他，舔着嘴唇。
Because dinosaurs are delicious.
因为恐龙很美味。
Keywords.
关键词。
Classmates.
同学。
Backpack.
书包。
Dinosaur.
恐龙。
Goldfish.
金鱼。
Eat.
吃。
Children.
孩子们。
Friend.
朋友。
The end.Do you like this story? I do. What I learned from the story is that whenever you eat your classmates, you'll never make friends.
从这个故事里我们学到，如果你想要交到朋友，千万不要吃你的同学，是不是？
Bye, see you next time!
Bye!